here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of UBS, which also announced plans to axe 3,000 jobs in Switzerland as it absorbs the local arm of Credit Suisse. Shares of UBS are trading in the green at 23.3 Swiss francs apiece. Also in focus, shares of Pernod Ricard, maker of Mumm Champagne and Absolut Vodka. That's after the world's second largest wine and spirit seller warned of an upcoming sales decline in China and the US. The stock is trading lower by over 4%. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Salesforce, owner of Slack. That's after its video conferencing rival Microsoft unbundled the team software in its offerings in Europe in a bid to appease regulators. This delivered a win to Salesforce, which is up over 5% in pre-market trading.
Let's check on European markets first. They're seeing mixed trade after Eurozone inflation came in higher than expected in August, matching July's figure of 5.3%. This raised bets the European Central Bank will continue to hike interest rates next month to tame inflation. UBS, however, is boosting sentiment after it reported a $29 billion second quarter profit in its first earnings results since taking over Credit Suisse. As for Wall Street, futures are in the green ahead of initial jobless claims data. Despite a possible fifth straight session of gains, Wall Street is headed for a monthly loss. Asian markets ended the month of August on a mixed note after China's factory activity contracted for a fifth straight month, though the figure came in softer than expected at 49.7. Chinese shares led declines in the region. The South Korean KOSPI also getting a drag from disappointing industrial output and retail sales data. Meanwhile, Japan's Nikkei outperformed. This is after the country's own retail sales data jumped more than expected in July. Some notable stock movements in the region. The Adani Group back in the headlines following fresh allegations of stock manipulation. Shares of its units tumbled at least 3% each. Meanwhile, despite a slump in Chinese markets, tech shares rose after the government allowed five firms, including listed firms Baidu and SenseTime, to launch AI chatbots. Here at home, Philippine shares bid August goodbye on a sour note. The main index shed nearly 2% to bring its monthly loss to 6%. Regina Capital's Ariel Santos also pointed to the MSCI rebalancing at the end of the month for the lower close.
On that rebal, we have around an outflow of over 50 million for the Philippines only. Okay. And that, I think, played a significant role into today's market performance. And that said, I think that the index is likely to open the month of September on a positive note, okay, mainly because usually traders take the next trading day of the rebalancing as a buying opportunity to, you know, pick up some badly beaten names.
Philippine businesses urged to bring more local brands abroad. Alegria Bing Siba Limhoco, known as the mother of Philippine franchising, says the move could boost economic growth and support job generation. She urges government to include the proposal in the Philippine Export Development Plan, which was approved by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. back in June, to boost the country's lagging exports sector.
Our Filipino brands have existed well overseas. When we export our brands, we are able to help not only in the products, but also they would need also our Filipino talents there.